Hey, it's Johara. Welcome back to my channel, to TV Fanatic. So, I'm going to be talking about First Kill, a new TV show that aired on Netflix. A little while ago, I watched it shortly after it got on Netflix. I liked First Kill a lot. I think I've already watched it twice, and it was really good. There were, what, 8 episodes or something like that? And I think they were like hour-long episodes. And I really hope there's a season 2. There hasn't been any news about renewal, but there better be, because that ending... No, I mean that ending was, oh my gosh. But I did really like it. I like the twist about, I mean, I love, as you guys probably know, I've done plenty of Buffy the Vampire Slayer videos, so I'm a huge fan, obviously. It's one of the first, like, adult shows I watched, that and Charmed. And, but Vampire Slayer was the classic story of a vampire hunter and a vampire. And... for those of you that like Buffy, I'm a Buffy shipper, just letting you know. But this was different because it's sapphic and I loved it. It was a diff when I first when I first found it, I was scrolling on Netflix because I was bored and trying to find something to watch. And I saw this and I decided to watch the trailer, and I really got intrigued by the concept of these two teenagers who fall in love against all odds, against the fact that their families are enemies. I mean, they had their issues at the beginning as well. One's a family in a family of vampire hunters, and one's in a family of vampires. So, yeah. But so much happened, and I don't even know where to begin. But I really enjoyed it. I loved Juliet and Calliope and their relationship, and the dynamic they have, the chemistry. It's just, they love each other so much, and they were willing to do anything for each other. Things did get rocky at the end, but the only reason why they were in so much pain at the end is because of how much they love each other. And I hope they can resolve the issues, though it's not going to be easy. I mean, those were some serious issues. But it was really good. I liked Calliope's dynamic with her family as well. I liked Juliet's dynamic with her dad the most, and her brother, because by the end, she got closer to her brother. Her brother had this whole thing where he was kind of disowned from his family because he was like this monster, even though you find out that it was his sister that's the real monster. I mean, not Juliet, his twin sister, the other one, I can't remember her name. But she was the real monster because she's kind of a serial killer. I mean, she kills guys, and then she lures in guys, she kills them, and she keeps it as a souvenir. So she's a serial killer, and she was a mass manipulator in the... I can't speak. Mass manipulator from a child. I'm pretty sure she's a sociopath. I'm not even kidding. Like, from some of the flashbacks we got of the two of them, of how she manipulated him to do these crazy little serial killer things to get her parents to think he was the bad one out of the two. And her face during them. She is a sociopath. And Julia figured that out at the end, and her and Oliver actually got pretty close, because by the end, she felt like he was the only one she could really go to. And Calliope was in a dilemma because she felt like, because there was really no one she could go to, because her entire family, I mean, I love the scene when Julia was in trouble because they think a vampire killed that one guy that had, you know, tried to hurt Calliope, and then Julia was the one that technically killed him. But, She brings Julia home, and then her parents freak out, and they find out that she had already been invited in, because she's already been here, and then they kind of just, Calliope stays in front of Julia as they kind of go upstairs, and that was awesome. I love that scene. Her parents were just so over it. But their parents do not get along, obviously, vampire hunters. But Julia and Calliope fall in love against all odds, and they fight for their relationship. I also love Juliet's best friend and her relationship with him. She's a lesbian, he's gay, and they are queer best friends, and I love it. I love that he obviously freaked out when he first found out she was a vampire, and was upset that Calliope knew first, because they've been best friends their entire lives. But he ends up getting over it pretty quickly, I say, and was always on her side, always trying to help, trying to stop his mom from the whole thing. She was like, his mom was creating this whole thing where, because they found out the monsters were back, so they were all trying, all these moms who wanted to protect their kids had joined a group, were trying to learn how to monster hunt so that they can stop them. and save their kids, and he was trying to stop her because he wants to protect Juliet. I really like Juliet's friendship with him and how loyal they are to each other. I just really like the show altogether. The ending, though, that was sad. I mean, so the brothers, Calliope's brothers, were fighting Juliet's sister when she moved out of the way, and one brother, Apollo? Which one is which? I'm trying to remember. I don't remember which one is which. One's Apollo and one is Artemis. But one of them stabbed the other by accident because she moved out of the way as he was trying to stab her. So, you know, he died. But Juliet and Calliope got there when, right after the fact, and Calliope and her brother left, the one that's still alive, obviously, left to go tell the parents and grieve and whatever, and Juliet stayed there to kind of clean up. But then later on, when Calliope and the brother got there, he was there and alive and fine. And turns out he was a vampire. You find out that Juliet turned it by accident. I mean, she knew there was the possibility, but that's not what she was trying to do. And so her and Calliope got into it, and they both were just crying and screaming into the air, and the dad was going to kill the son because he's a monster now, but the mom still loved him and couldn't do it. And this is a lot considering she didn't give birth to him, she just raised him since he was a baby, or not baby, but like pretty young. He was really young when she married his dad. She took him to Oliver's to protect him because they had her and Oliver had a moment before. And it was really sweet because Oliver made a comment about her being a good mother and said that my mother doesn't care about me. And she's like, that's not possible. All mothers care about their children. And so she trusted Oliver enough to take care of her kid at that point, which was really nice. But that ending was so sad. So they don't get it. If we don't get season two, I'm gonna be mad because I want to find out what happens and I want it to be resolved because you cannot end Clive being Juliet's story like that. But I mean, that wasn't the real end because after she dropped him off, Oliver and his witch girlfriend led, I think Apollo was the older one, the one that got turned to a vampire. But so they took Apollo to the back and where they saw a whole bunch of monsters, which is why all of a sudden this town for the first time in a long time is being riddled with monsters because apparently Oliver and his witch girlfriend has a bunch of them, and I'm guessing he's releasing them. You did find out that Oliver was the one that turned the girl that died earlier into a banshee, or no, zombie. Why did I say banshee? I don't know, zombie. Because there was that going on, and you did find out that Oliver was and his girlfriend was the one that did that. Got upset that Juliet and Calliope killed her, even though they had no choice. But yeah, so that's kind of how it ended, and I need to find out what happened. But all in all, it was a really good show so far, and I really enjoyed it. And there better be a season two. I cannot wait to find out what happens next.
I'm from a lineage thousands of years old of the best monster hunters to ever walk the earth.
Even on good days, I feel like I still don't fit in. Like everyone else has it all figured out.
Oh yeah, that.
I haven't told anyone, of course.
You are a legacy vampire, made vampires with love. See their reflection in a mirror.
We're hunters.
More importantly, you're my daughter.
Which is why we've decided you're ready for your first kill.
Used to killing monsters.
Your body is changing.
Yeah, my body.
But very soon, you are going to have to make your first kill.
Hi.
It's Juliet, right?
Yeah. You're Calliope?
Well, Cal's good.
Who are you, Calliope? Where'd you come from?
Addicted to loving you. How does it feel?
You're nothing like the monsters I grew up hating.
I just want to live my life.
Can't be together. It won't work.
I've forbidden you from seeing her.
We're not supposed to be.
I know my feelings for you are real.
Juliet and every legacy in Savannah dies tonight.
Run now!
I'll kill for you.
Pussy mouth. We won't have a problem.
We will always have a problem.
I had to choose between you and my family. I choose my family.
What about us?
Faced everyone, monster and human, who tried to come between us. We got this.
I'll kill for you.
So please like and subscribe and comment if you've seen First Kill, if you want to watch it, if you like it at all. And I'll chat with you below in the comments. Until next time.